Hi, all you SPMEs out there. Today's question has three answers, and you're going to want to stick around because the third answer is a secret to telling you exactly what it will take in order to make money if you choose to write in young adult literature. Now, let's get into it. The question that was sent in to me today was, can you make money with self-published YA books? Now, the person who asked this question is clearly wondering a little bit about maybe they should start writing young adult books, or maybe you've written young adult books and you're not sure whether or not it was a good idea, because after all, how do you even know they're profitable? And so this is a very good question, because you're asking about whether the market itself, the niche that you'd be going into, is a profitable one. And I am planning on helping you with that exact question in today's video. This is Chris Baird from selfpublishingmadeeasynow.com, where self-publishing doesn't have to be so hard. Click the subscribe button if you would like for me to make more videos like this one, and check out below in the link in my description, and you will find my absolutely free self-publishing checklist that will help you make sure you are not skipping any of the necessary steps to make money with self-publishing. So let's get into it. Can you make money with self-published young adult books? Well, when I first started, I was writing in the nonfiction area, and I wrote a number of books that were in that area. They were not particularly optimized when I was writing them because I didn't understand what was necessary. And that made me think maybe I should start writing books in the fiction area and not just the nonfiction area, when in reality, that was not the case. Because in some ways, it's a lot easier to make money and find books in the nonfiction because people are doing searches on keywords, whereas in the fiction area, usually the keyword searches would be a book. Maybe they would look in a genre or a sub, like a niche or sub niche, for example, or perhaps they would look for books that are like other books that they are already reading. And so this plays a very important role, and especially when we're looking at the young adult literature and trying to figure out how does it fit within the overall pool of all the books that are being put onto the market. So, can you make money with self-published YA books? Well, here's a couple of the answers. First is yes, this has been a very popular and profitable niche for many years. Some of the top-selling books of all time, whether we're looking at J.K. Rowling's with Harry Potter, or we're looking at the Chronicles of Narnia, C.S. Lewis, there's a whole series of books that have sold an awful lot of copies. And so young adult literature is a very profitable niche if you're going to choose a niche to write in. The second answer is that you should only write in the niche if you actually enjoy writing in young adult literature. The worst thing you can do is to start writing in a niche for which you really do not enjoy that writing, because we're going to be needing to do it for a very long time if we're going to win. And that we'll be getting into that, because that's exactly where our third answer and the secret of winning in the young adult literature niche. It's the fact that the key to winning is to stick in that niche or sub-niche for the long haul. You're going to be writing book after book after book. You're going to get better with each book, and you should not switch which sub-niche or niche that you're marketing to, just like J.K. Rowling did. Now, if you become an insanely bestseller, then perhaps you can try to write some other stuff. One of the problems is that people jump from niche to niche without ever building any authority and building an audience in that particular niche. In addition, when you come out with a new book, some of the people who may have loved your previous book, they will then choose to buy the new book only to discover that you switched niches on them, and they will give you terrible reviews as a result. Even if the new niche that you're writing on, let's say you go from young adult and suddenly you're writing on adult horror, there can be a backlash against you on both directions. They just find it confusing. Are you, what type of author are you? You're writing in too many niches. So this is the reason I was exactly telling you that you're going to want to, first of all, stick with it for the long haul. Make sure you actually enjoy it. And if you do, then it is a very profitable niche. I like to figure out, in terms of the sub-niches, which one's going to be most popular by looking at what are the best-selling books currently, and then looking in those sub-niches to see if there's some gold, some little gold nuggets that are hiding in there, and then choose one of those niches. So, but in the end, you need to make sure that you do, in fact, enjoy writing in this niche. So, can you make money with self-published YA books? What have you found? Have you written in them? Have you made money off of them? Or are you just considering it? Let me know what you found below in the comments. I respond to 100% of the comments. And check up above me here for more answers to your self-publishing questions. Thanks.